inside Chichen Itza and about to take the tour.
Have a duality, and this duality will be represented with animals, okay? You need the support of the animals to make the contact with the heaven or the underworld. Why? Because the Mayas were made by the god Kukulkan. Watch on the front, can you see the snake heads? Yeah. Those two snake heads are the Kukulkan head, the god of the lightning. On the Mayan mythology, Kukulkan descend into the underworld and stole the plant of corn, mixed with his blood to make the Mayas. The Mayas are made from the plant of corn and from the blood of Kukulkan, feather serpent, god of the lightning. So, like their children, at the beginning the Mayas had the same skill of the gods. The Mayas were able to watch and understand everything on this world. But the god of the creation, the big boss, say that was too much for the Mayas, and this god blind our eyes, and we lost all those skills. And today the Mayas, to make the contact with the heaven or the underworld, need the support of the animals. So you need this duality. Every person, every woman, every man need a duality. For this reason, sometimes you will watch on the paintings the Mayas using clothes like animals, like a jaguar, like a bear, like a snake, because represent their dualities. How the Mayas choose those dualities? Your fathers will do it for you. It's like a bad sin. When you're a baby, your fathers draw a circle all around your house, and the first animal that touch this circle will be your duality. Could be an iguana, a doggy, snakes, butterflies, any kind of animal. Now, even the gods have dualities, but the gods have double dualities. In this case, the jaguar is the representation of the god of the sun into the underworld. When you watch the sunrise, this jaguar will become an eagle. The eagle will fly to the top, and then on the top will back to be the sun. Today you'll watch many jaguars and eagles all around the village, because represent the mythological cycle of the sun into the underworld and on the heaven, okay? Now, amigos, who is the people that had the access to this room? Only three people had the access: the king, the queen, and the priest. Nobody else. We can say that this building is like a big phone, is the way that the Mayas have to make contact with the gods on the heaven or the gods into the underworld. Okay, okay. Now, amigos, as can you see over there on the corner, we have the door. Can you see the door? Yeah. This is the access to go to watch the jaguar throne at the god of the corn. And as can you see on the front, two snake heads. Those two snake heads are the Kukulkan's head, the god of the lightning, the feather serpent. Why two snake heads? Because like the sun, Kukulkan have a double duality. Kukulkan is a snake into the underworld, and on the heaven will be a quetzal. What is a quetzal? It's a bird. And more later I'm going to show you this animal. But it's very important that we understand that Kukulkan, feather serpent, god of the lightning, and the Mayan gods, amigos, are real and are still alive. Yeah, the Mayans worship the sun, and watch, there is the sun. Our god is alive. They worship the jungle, and watch this place is still green, is still alive. They worship the wind, you're feeling the breeze. And yes, amigos, Mr. Kukulkan, to watch Kukulkan alive, you have to back on the right days. 21 of March, 21 of September. What's going on those days? If you back on those days, this is the north side. The north side that you're watching will be completely covered by the shadows. But if you wait at the sunset, amigos, only at the sunset, the sunlight will make exactly 7 perfect triangles, beginning from the top to the bottom. Will connect with the snake head and looks like a golden snake made by the sunlight. This is Kukulkan, feather serpent, god of the lightning. But sorry, amigos, not today. You are on the wrong day. I have a picture. Would you like to watch the picture? Okay, amigos, if you back on those days, you will watch the next thing. Let me show you. There is tram. Can you see?
Yeah.
7 golden triangles connecting with the snake head, and looks like a golden snake made by the sunlight. This is Kukulkan, amigos. Amigos, how many triangles?
7.
Which day to watch this phenomenon? 21. Divide 21 by 3? 7. How many minutes to watch this phenomenon? It's only at the sunset, 43 minutes, and will disappear. 4 plus 3, 7. The number 7 repeat all around this place like a lucky number. Beautiful, right? Now, what is the meaning, amigos? What's going on 21 of March? Beginning of the spring, the perfect time for the plantation. 21 of September again, autumn, fall, the perfect time for the harvest. The building is a calendar to let you know the right moment for the plantation and the harvest. Why the Mayas need to know that? Food, and the Mayas are socially based on agriculture. The Mayas worship and they are depending of the plants. Now, what the Mayas discover in the seasons? No, amigos, because this is Yucatan, Mexico, and in Yucatan, Mexico, we don't have seasons. This place is just hot, 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 and hot. The only meaning of this phenomenon are the equinox. What is the equinox? The cycle of the sun. Because remember, amigos, the Mayas will watch the nator, they will worship the nator, they will watch the sun, right about the cycle of the sun. And one time they have this knowledge, they will sit on the architecture of the building. Okay? Equinox. Just this. Equinox. What is the equinox? It's the cycle of the sun. On the equinox, we have the shortest and the largest day of the year. And not only that, if you put attention on the equinox, there will be the sun, but you will lose your shadows. No shadows 21 March or 21 September, because only on those 2 days, the sun will set on the top of the earth and the sunlight will not have a chance to project your shadow. But amigos, if you watch Chichen Itza on those days, watch, the north side will be covered by the shadows. Can you see? How is that possible? It's supposed that no shadows. This is because you have to go to the south side. You will take a picture of the building and you will realize that the building is not completely straight. It's in this position. Half an angle of 17 grades on the north side, enough to make 7 triangles every 21 March, every 21 of September. Is this a coincidence? Is a mistake? Amigos, it's intentional and was made by the Mayas. How? No computers, no technology, no Google, no iPhones, no Siri, nothing like this. No, this is our technology. The Mayas have a better technology. You only need 2 things. Watch the stars and a lot of free time. Just this. Okay, amigos, now you know the Quetzal, but to hear the Quetzal again, you don't have to go to Guatemala, you don't need my phone. You only have to back to Chichen Itza, stand in front of the steps and clap, and you will hear the Quetzal. Let me show you, amigos, I'll do it for you. Listen, amigos. Ta-dan! Quetzal! All together, follow me! There is the Quetzal, amigos. Is this a mistake? Is a coincidence? Who did that? The aliens? No, amigos. Where the Mayas is working on every side, only in front of the steps. What is the meaning? Amigos, we don't know. Okay? We only have 3 books, and those 3 books only are talking about calendars, rituals, genesis, but not about architecture. To discover all those kind of things, we have to start from zero, like the Mayas did it. Maybe the Mayas played 21 on March, you know, with the snake made by the sunlight, or maybe the Mayas used to dance. Because remember, amigos, the Mayas didn't pray. The Mayas prefer to dance. Why? Because the earth is alive, it's sleeping, and when you are dancing, you are trying to wake up the earth. The dancing is an offering for the Mayas. Now, how is working this phenomenon? I want to explain, but I want to explain to you on this building over there, the Mayan ball game, the access to the underworld. There I want to explain how it's working this phenomenon. Come with me, follow me please. This is the next building. Okay, amigos, watch. This building is the Mayan ball game, the ball court. Now, amigos, what is that? The Mayan ball game, the ball court, is the access to the underworld. Amigos, today we have many religions. The most part of the time, the people have the idea that when you die, you will go to the heaven. Not for the Mayas. If you are Maya and you die, you will go into the underworld. Now, be careful with those words, because the underworld is not the hell of the church. This name, underworld, is your understanding. What is the right name of the underworld of the Mayas? Please, amigos, repeat with me. Xibalba. Perfect. Xibalba is the underworld and it's a big star. And if you are Maya and you die, you will travel to the Xibalba to start a new life after this one. Now, it's not so simple. You have to fight to get this new life. You'll have to play the Mayan ball game. This one that you're watching against the gods into the underworld. If you are the winner, you will start the next life. But if you lost the game, the gods into the underworld will cut your head and will plant in a pumpkin plant to spend your eternity like a pumpkin. Yeah. Now, amigos, please watch on the top. Can you see the jaguars? We have many jaguars, and there on the front, we have a jaguar throne. Can you see the jaguar throne? Yeah. Amigos, what is the jaguar meaning? It's the sun into the underworld. This building is the access to the underworld, so you will watch the sun like a jaguar. But why exactly the jaguar? Because I told you that at the sunset, the sun will descend into the underworld and will become a jaguar. To do what? To sleep? No. the son will go there to play the Mayan ball game, because one of the most important players of this game is the son. But the son will do it asking for a good harvest. Why the son have to play the Mayan ball game asking for a good harvest? Because on the Mayan mythology, the son is the children of the god of the corn. So the son will play this ritual asking for a good life for his father, the god of the corn. Okay? Now, the Mayans will set the jaguars, because it's like today, when you go to watch a game, you will watch pictures of important players at the access of the stadium. It's the same. The Mayans will recreate this ritual asking for a good harvest for them, and they will set the pictures of the jaguar to remember this mythological player. Let's watch closer. Come with me. You see, there are four pillars. Can you see? And every pillar is being covered by carvings. There were people, something that looked like people, but as can you see, the only remainder of the legs. Can you see? We had capitals. Chichen Itza was a capital, and the capitals, like today, used to fight to control the economy, the natural resource. In this case, the coast, because the salt, the seafood, and the volcans. Why the volcans? Because we don't use metals. We are going to use only beautiful stones from the volcans, so they will fight. Chichen Itza had enemies, and the biggest and stronger enemy of Chichen Itza is Mayapan. Do you know Mayapan? Somebody? No? It's like that. 80 kilometers from this point. 1200, Chichen Itza start a war against Mayapan. They start to fight. Who was the winner? Chichen Itza or Mayapan? Mayapan. 1200 is the end of Chichen Itza, because Mayapan destroyed, and you're like a Maya, you have to destroy the face of the local gods to humiliate, to destroy their power, to make collapse. They worship the same gods, but they will do it to destroy their power. And remember, amigos, we worship the same gods, but the gods are changing depending on what they need, okay? Because on this place they worship Kukulkan, but maybe on Mayapan they worship the planet Venus. They are changing the gods, and remember, you have many options, because in total the Mayas have 164 gods. We worship everything. Now, they destroy the face of the gods, okay? In the middle of the wars, there were some gods that you will never touch, because are the gods of the creation. Example, this one. Come with me. Can you see this man? In this case, it's a man, but if you want to watch over there, sometimes it's like a snake. Can you see? If you watch on the corners, there are more snakes. Are the representation of Vulcan. Let me show you a picture, a better representation. There is. So, maybe you're in war, but you will never touch Kukulkan, because we are the children of Kukulkan. Kukulkan made the Mayas with his blood and the plant of corn. And as can you see, was painted with a red color. Can you see the remain of red color? Sometimes blue, yellow, green color. Amigos, if you want to watch more colors, come with me. On this corner, on the top, this roof is the only part that is conserving the colors. Come on, closer. Take your time. Watch over there from this point.
Can you see the colors? It's green, red, blue, yellow.
Okay, amigos, as can you see, this one, it's complete. Can you see? They didn't destroy this one. Why? Because this one, like Kukulkan, is one of the gods of the creation. This one they are watching is the big boss, is the god of the gods, Ipsamna. This one is Ipsamna, the god of the creation, is the most stronger and important god that they have. This god, Ipsamna, is the one that blind the eyes of the Mayas, and we lost the communication with the heaven underworld, and today we need the support of the animals to make those contacts. Now, how could we know that this one is Ipsamna? Watch his face. It's an old man with just one teeth. Can you see? Yeah. And as can you see on the breast, have a big necklace with a big pendant. Can you see the pendant? This pendant that looks like an eye is a cacao bean. Do you know the cacao bean? What is that?
Chocolate.
Chocolate. Do you like the chocolate?
Yeah.
Amigos, do you know which people domesticate the plant of chocolate? Amigos, no Mexico, no Mayas, no chocolate. So if you like the chocolate, you should love the Mayas, amigos. Because thanks to the Mayas, you can enjoy the chocolate. For the Mayas, the chocolate, like the corn, is a sacred plant. Okay, amigos, watch. Now we are into the Mayan ball game. We are into the underworld. And amigos, watch. It's big like a football field. Just for this reason, the people will name Mayan ball game. But amigos, it's wrong. This is not the name. What is the name? Would you like to know?
Yes.
Okay, but first, remember me the first of the big one, the first building. Remember the name of the first building that you were watching? How? Wits. Remember, amigos? Wits, mountain, hills. What is the name of this one? Please repeat. Pits. Which pitch? Pitch which? Like the pizza, something like this. What is the pitch meaning? We don't know. Our language is dying, okay? And remember, huh? Yeah, pitch, but what is the meaning? What is the translation? No idea. Remember, we only are able to understand the 80% of the Mayan writing system, so the pitch meaning is missing, okay? But very important, it's not a game, it's not a sport. This is a ritual trying to recreate the cycle of the sun, because the first player of this ritual is the sun, like a jaguar. When you watch the sunrise, it's the victory of the sun will back like an eagle and will fly again to back to the top on the heaven, to back to be the sun. Now, amigos, who is the only people allowed to play this ritual? Warriors, of course, Mayas, but only the warriors. Why? Why the warriors? Because the Mayas only have two warriors, the eagle and jaguar warriors. The warriors, the soldiers, are the representation of the sun on the earth. So only those warriors will have the chance to play this ritual. Could be local players, sometimes visitor players. Two teams. Amigos, how many players on every team? Lucky number?
Seven.
Seven and seven. And every one of those players need a uniform made from rubber to protect your body. Why do you need to protect your body? Because the ball is made with the same rubber, bouncing with a weight of 4 kilograms, 8 pounds, that could break your bones. Ah, it's dangerous. And no hands, no legs, it's forbidden. You'll have to use shoulders, torso, and knees. Just this. To do what? To dunk the ball. Where? Into those rings on the top. We have a platform on each side. This is because we had 6 players on the field playing with those parts of their body, and they will have to pass the ball to this platform. There on the platform was waiting a captain with a wooden stick to dunk the ball. A little more easy. Amigos, today we're still playing this ritual, and trust me, it's not so hard as you believe, okay? Could take you 5 minutes or 30 minutes, it's according to your skills, okay? It's like the football, you know, a big area to put the ball, but 2 hours and nobody will make a goal. It's the same with the Mayans. Now, amigos, how many points to end the game?
1-7.
Just one, amigos. Why? Because I told you, it's not a sport, it's not a game. This is a ritual trying to recreate the cycle of the sun. So this only point is the sunrise and the end of the game. Now is the end of the game. We have to celebrate. How? Dancing, party, alcohol, and at the end, one of the captains will be beheaded, asking for a good harvest. Because I told you, we have to pay. We will pay with blood, like the god of the corn did it at the beginning. Now, the winner, the loser, we don't know, amigos. No idea. We don't have a way to discover something like this. But one of the captains was beheaded. But if you want, we could discover it. Would you like to play with me?
No.
No? Okay. Now, amigos, please watch all around the building. Can you see stands to watch the game?
No.
No stands, amigos. I told you, it's not a sport, it's not a game. The citizens didn't have access. The only people allowed to watch this game are the royalty, nobody else. King, queen, priest, people of money, beast, royalty, nobody else is pay-per-view. And as can you see, on each side, we have thrones. Can you see the thrones?
Mm-hmm.
For the rulers. Visitor, local ruler. They're on the top.
What happened?
Watch the visitor and remember, like 2 presidents, they have to talk about business. But watch the distance, it's very far. And remember, they were Mayas. No phones, no WhatsApp. How the Mayas got to communicate each other? Any idea?
A bird. Screen.
Just talking, amigos. No, you don't need the screen. Just talking. It's a normal conversation because the best point of this place is on the top of the thrones. When you go on the top, you are able to talk with the people on the other side without screaming. Just a normal conversation. How is that possible? It's like the Quetzal on the other building. It's thanks to this stone. This stone that you're watching is limestone. The limestone is being covered by microscopic holes that are like little caves that safe reproduce and make a distortion on the echo. How is that possible? This is because the limestone that you're watching, this stone, is organic. It's made from fish bones, shells, coral reef, and dinosaurs. Why? Because 65 million years ago, this part of Mexico, Yucatan, was under the ocean, and the explosion of the asteroid that killed the dinosaurs was here. With explosion, wow! All the ocean floor got to the surface, and all those little animals becoming fossils. Limestone. If you go into the jungle and you find a mite made from limestone and you clap, you will hear taka 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 taka. The Mayans realized of this property and they learned to work to set acoustic phenomena on the buildings according to the size and the position of the blocks. Those two big walls that you're watching are like two big speakers. Your voice will buzz on the walls till I ride to the other side. Watch the size of the blocks. Big blocks, right? Big blocks. Now watch the other side.
Frescos.
Small blocks. Now watch the other side. Small blocks. Watch on the front. Big blocks. According to the size and the position, you will get different acoustic phenomena. Your voice will bounce on the walls till I ride to the other side. You don't need to scream. It's just a normal conversation. And I want to show you this phenomenon. But we have to go there. And before to go there, I want to show you the warriors, the players, the warriors on the carvings. More jaguars on the top. Two big pillars, rattle a snake, who will come feather serpent, god of the lightning. And on the front, those steps that you are watching are the only stands to watch this game. Can you see? Only for the royalty. Remember, it's pay-per-view, only the royalty, okay? Come with me. You will find two snakes, two crossed snakes making the ring. Can you see? Do you like the snakes? Yes? Amigos, two snakes. What is the snake meaning? For the Mayas, knowledge, fertility, power is a very appreciated animal, and not only for the Mayas. Amigos, what is the symbol of the doctors and hospitals? Snakes! It's the same. Not only for the Mayas, it's the same if you go to China, Japan, India, Philippines, Australia, Thailand. The snake is a very appreciated animal. Not for the church. For the church is the evil. And watch, can you see the warriors? There are two warriors. Please, amigos, the Mayas didn't have size like the meters, feet, inch, something like this. They will use only the size of the body, just this. Please, when you watch somebody on the wall, it's because they were like this size. Check the size. Like my wooden stick, they were very short, like this size. They are still being very short. And watch, with all those clothes to protect their body, with big piercings on their nose, and as can you see, this one looks angry, and this one is happy. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, come with me, 6. Over there is the number 7. Come with me to watch the number 7, amigos. Please, on the front. Can you see this man?
Yes.
Long hair like Frank, big person on the nose, and as can you see, he's holding a big knife. Can you see?
Yes.
Made from beautiful stones, not from metal. And please, watch the left hand. He's holding a human head. Can you see? So we have the captain with the other captain's head. Who is the winner? Who is the loser? There's no symbols to read, amigos. We don't know. And as can you see in the middle, we have this human skull with a mohawk. And since that is smoking, this smoke is a voluta, is a glyph, is the symbol of the speech. When you watch a smoke emerging from the mouth of the things, it's because they are trying to talk. This one is trying to talk because this skull is a pooch. A pooch is the lord of the dead. And he's talking with this man. Watch, on the front, we have this man on his knees. Can you see?
Mm-hmm.
On this position, and as can you see, with no head. Where is the head? It's on the other side. And as can you see, the blood is flowing like snakes. Can you see the snakes? How many snakes? 7 snakes, and the blood is flowing over there. And he's feeding vegetables, flowers. His blood is feeding the plants. Because this is a ritual asking for a god. The man will feed the plants, not the plants feed the man. Beautiful. Remember, they have a beautiful idea of this world. Let's go. Come with me, amigos. Hello? 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 Can you hear that bouncing? Is your voice bouncing on the walls till I ride to the other side? And the best point, it's over there on the top. Let's try it. Come with me. Amigos, I forget to say to you that you are touching 1,000 years old of Mayan legacy. They had touching something old or something old like this. 1,000 years old of Mayan legacy. Yours like to touch a dinosaur. Are not just stones. Those stones represent who we are, from where we are coming, and we are the Mayas. We never disappear. We're still alive. You are touching the passion and the work of all these people. Remember, by years, they were working, they will carry all those stones with their hands on their back to build all this, because they believe in all those kind of things. And there's the remain. We are going to disappear, we are going to die, but those stones, those buildings will stay here forever. The best friend of the man are not the doggies, are the stones, because the stones have been with us from the beginning to protect us, and sometimes even to destroy us. Okay, amigos, The best point is on the top. When you go there to the top to take a seat, you will talk with the people on the other side without screaming. Just a normal conversation, and it's thanks to the echo on those walls. But remember, the echo is like a radio web. When somebody is there in the middle of the field, it's like an interference. We're better with no people and no wind and on the top. I'll try it. Maybe it's not going to work, I don't know, but we have to try it. So please be quiet and try to hear my claps. I'll start with two claps. Try to hear my claps on the other side. Shh. Listen. Can you hear the claps? Now listen. Hello? 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 Can you hear my hello on the other side?
Yeah.
Now you all together, you have to say hello. One, two, three.
Hello. Hello.
One more time. One, two, three.
Hello. Hello.
A little bit more stronger. One, two, three.
Hello. Hello.
Can you hear that? I told you, you don't need to scream. And what better we have all these people in the middle talk, you don't need to scream, okay? Now listen to me. Hello? 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 Now, you're like me. You have to say, hello? Just one time, hello. Very powerful with all your power. One, two, three.
Hello?
Okay, give me more. Very powerful with all your power, amigos. Imagine that your life is depending, okay? One, two, three.
Hello!
Can you hear that?
Yeah.
Beautiful. It's Mayan technology made from stones. We were like the Flintstones. It's like an ancient Wi-Fi. Let's go, amigos. Let's go to watch the next thing. Can you see? Do you like the skulls?
Yeah.
Do you have to wonder why the Mexicans love the skulls? Would you like to know?
Yeah.
Because we are crazy. Now, this is because we worship the dead, amigos. And remember, the dead is not bad, it's just part of the process of the life. And amigos, today the most part of the Mexicans are changing to the Catholic religion. When you die, you will have to go to the graveyard, to the cemetery, something like this. Not for the Mayas, amigos. If you are Maya and you die, your family will take your body and bury it into the house. All the families stay together at the center of the house. For this reason, we love to say to the children, respect your grandmother, or she will back in the night to pull your leg, because you're sleeping with your grandmother. This is the beginning. Now, was it stinky? No, amigos, wasn't stinky. Why? Because the Mayans will take this stone, limestone, they cook and smash to make lime. They will cover the body with lime and will dry the water. So it's like a mummification, something like this. And remember, every 52 years, we have to celebrate the party of the new fire. Remember this party? The new beginning for the Mayas. On this party, the Mayas will board the house. But before to board the house, they will open the tomb and they will extract your skull. Because your skull is the immortal part of you they will save. And amigos, every year we have to celebrate Party of the Dead, Dia de Muertos. Do you know Dia de Muertos?
Mm-hmm.
What's going on this party? By 3 days, you have a special permission to back from the underworld to the earth, to share 3 days with your family. But you need something to stay on this place, so they will use your skull to stay on this place. They will open the tomb, they clean, cover it with flowers, and they will surround with your favorite food. Are very important for the Mexicans, because remember, your family is not dead, only is into the underworld, and you will share those 3 days. But amigos, arrive the church, and the church said, I don't like me, you have to stop to do that. And the people trying to save the tradition start to make the skulls with ceramic, clay, wax, sometimes with candies, with sugar. And today, this idea to save the skull of our family is becoming in a souvenir. For this reason, sometimes, like over there, you will watch all those skulls. All those skulls over there, souvenirs, are the remain of the party, the tradition, to save the skull of our family. Got your idea?
Yeah.
Okay, now. Today the people is changing to the Catholic religion. Some people try to save the tradition and is backing to use the real school, but other people don't have this chance. So sometimes the Mexicans will go to the cemetery, to the graveyard, they will clean the tomb and they will sleep on the tomb by 3 days. Could you do that? No? Why? Amigos, there's no ghosts, there's no zombies. There is your family, okay? For the Mexicans are very important. We have to go to stay those 3 days with our family because they are not dead. They are with us. Now, this building that you're watching is not a witch. This is a zompantli. What is a zompantli meaning? wall of skulls, wall of human heads, and amigos, the Zompantli was used by them to celebrate the end of the wars. I told you we have capitals, sometimes they fight, and very important, the royalties will go to fight their wars, okay? Now, they will catch alive your enemies, but only warriors, only royalties. No people, no cities, no farmer, no hunter, no children, nothing like this, no woman. Only royalties and warriors, they will catch alive. They will back to the city, and they're on the top. They will behead every one of them. Take the head and display in spears, like you're watching on the walls. Why they will take your head? Because I told you, for you and your family, is a very important part. When they take your head, for you and your family, is like an offense, because you are missing something important. You are missing the immortal part of your family. And not only that, it's a trophy of war, and at the end, it's a display of power to control the people through the fear. Let me show you a picture to help you to understand, amigos. Don't worry, not real schools, it's a draw. There is something like this. Can you see? Now, amigos, imagine you decide to go to Chichen Itza, to go to the market, to visit your friends, your girlfriend, your boyfriend, I don't know, and you watch all those human skulls on the top, and you ask to the locals, hey amigo, what's going on with those human skulls? Oh, are the people that didn't pay taxes? Oh my God, take my money. You will pay your taxes. So it's a display of power to let you know what is going to happen to you if you don't respect Chichen Itza. Okie dokie, are you okay? Are you sure? Okay, let's go to watch the front. On the front we have more information, more carvings. Please amigos, as can you see, no more skulls. Now the carvings are different and are beautiful. Beautiful carvings. Can you see the warriors? We have warriors and eagles on the walls, can you see? Over there, can you see this warrior? With a big person on the nose, holding a human head, can you see? We have the warriors recollecting human heads. This is the end of the wars, it's the representation. And as can you see, the warrior is being surrounded by snakes. Can you see the snakes? How many snakes? 7 snakes, what is the snake meaning? Kukulkan, feather serpent, god of lightning, supporting your power, because it's the main god on this place. Like a snake, like a rattlesnake, or like the big feather serpent, Kukulkan, god of the lightning. Now, those warriors that you're watching are the eagle warriors. Can you see? They are being surrounded by the eagles. It's the representation of the sun on the heaven. Could be a jaguar, so should be a jaguar warrior. Now, watch the cloud. The eagle is holding something in the cloud. What is that, amigos? It's holding a human heart. Oh. It's trying to eat a heart? No, because this eagle is not an eagle. This is a why. What is a why? This is the name of your duality. No spirits, no souls, we have whys. This is the name. This why is an eagle, and is the why of this animal, sorry, of this man, is his duality. And amigos, the most strong your mayas will have enough power to become, to transform on those animals. So be careful with the things that you watch on the walls, because you'll not watch people, you'll not watch animals, you will watch the wise, the fusion of the man with his duality. In this case, the eagle. And please watch the eagle claw. Amigos, do you have seen an eagle with a claw like this one? This is not an eagle claw, it's a human arm, a human hand. Can you see? It's the fusion of the man with his duality. They are making the contact. And amigos, it's not trying to eat the heart, it's trying to talk with the heart. Now, we have to go to watch this one, and you will understand. The carvings are in better condition. Come with me. Just watch the eagle. Can you see the eagle? It's a beautiful carving. And please, again, watch the cloud. It's holding a human heart, can you see? But please watch the mouth. From the mouth is emerging something that looks like a mustache, can you see? Like a smoke. This mustache, again, is the glyph of the voluta, the symbol of the speech. That means that the eagle is trying to talk with the heart. Where is the owner of this heart? They're on the top. Can you see those two men on the top? They are the owners. In the middle was the jaguar. Come with me to watch the other side. Eagle holding human heart. And in the panel in the middle is the jaguar. Can you see the jaguar? Again holding a human heart. And watch the jaguar mouth. From the mouth is emerging this smoke surrounding the heart. The cloud is the jaguar trying to talk with the heart. Beautiful carvings. But amigos, remember, this is not an eagle, this is not a jaguar. Please put attention on the jaguar and tell me, do you have seen a jaguar with a human arm, with a human elbows? It's not a jaguar, it's a why, it's the fusion of the man with the duality. Where is the owner? Where is the man? On the top, on the panel of the top, we have those two men on this position, can you see? Holding a wooden stick, holding a bazooka, something like this. Those two men on the top are two captains of the Mayan ball game. Remember, only these people had a lowet. Where a lowet? to play the Mayan ball game. And please watch the man on the right side. Watch his mouth. From his mouth is emerging the smoke. Looks like a snorkel, can you see?
Yeah.
They are trying to talk each other. And please remember this position. Can you see? Like a baby, like a fetus, because they are trying to imitate the god of the corn. Amigos, I told you that every time you watch offerings, you will find the god of the corn surrounding this place. Where is the god of the corn on this occasion? Follow me, it's over here. Chacmol, red hand, red cloud, god of the corn, can you see? Every time you find the god of the corn, you'll be all around this place offerings. Where are the offerings? Platform of the eagles and jaguars. This building was just to celebrate the end of the Mayan ball game, and this one, the Zompantli, to celebrate the end of the wars. Again, like a baby, like a fetus. And remember, sometimes they had public chacmols. You are like a Maya, you had the chance to go there to set your offerings. What kind of offerings? Flowers, food, beautiful stones. But if you really want to do that, will be blood offerings. Would you like to try? Blood offerings? No? Nobody? It's like today when you watch the National Geographic, sometimes you will find these people piercing their body. This is the immolation, the blood and the pain is the offering that you're making for the gods. It's the same with the Mayas. Tómelo! Amigos, on the Mayan mythology, there are some animals, special animals, that you cannot touch. For example, the iguana. Why you cannot touch the iguanas? Because I told you, we worship the corn. The corn is a god, and every time the Mayas make a representation of the god of the corn, will be with three animals. A doggy, macaw, parrot, and an iguana. So, just for this reason, we don't touch those animals, because they are like the friends of the god of the corn. This is a boy. Shh. Attack! Amigos, this one is the platform of the planet Venus. The Mayas worship the planet Venus. Of course, we don't say Venus. How the Mayas name the planet Venus? Please repeat with me. Ek. Ek. Exactly. This is the planet Venus. Now, Venus could be a good boy and represent fertility for everything, or sometimes will be a warrior. For example, the Mayan city Mayapan that destroyed Chichen Itza, they worship the planet Venus, but the warrior Venus. So, the god Kukulkan, feather serpent, god of lightning of Chichen Itza, was defeated by the warrior Venus. Now, where is Venus on this building? There on the corner, can you see this flower? There is a big flower, looks like a star or like a flower with blade on the petals. This symbol is the representation of the good planet Venus. In this case, Venus represents fertility for everything. This building is a public building, a public platform. You like a Maya, you'll have the chance to go there to set your offerings. If you watch in the middle, we have we have this panel with a snake jaws, and this man emerging from the jaws, can you see? There is a man on this position with a snake jaws. This one in the middle is Kukulkan, feather serpent, god of the lightning. Let's watch the other side. Can you see Venus on the corner, Ek? Yeah. And there in the middle, Kukulkan. And if you watch on the other corner, the remain of the colors. Can you see the colors? We have the blue and red color, are the real colors. And please watch in the top, we have a snake head, can you see? The Kukulkan's head. And if you watch on the top, on this panel on the top, we have the snake body being surrounded by the plumes, can you see? The snake body surrounded by the plumes, can you see? Kukulkan. And please, amigos, put attention on the snake body, and you will find that the snake body is being surrounded by fish. Can you see those fish? Now, please put attention on those fish, and you will realize that those fish are not fish, are plant of corn. Can you see? It's not fish, it's corn. What's going on with that? What's going on with that? I told you, this is the platform of Ek, the planet Venus, represents fertility. So when they say those corn, it's like asking for a good fertility for this plant. Amigos, do you like the corn? Amigos, which country domesticates the plant of corn? Who? Who? Mexico! Amigos, no Mexicans, no Mexico, no Mayas, no corn. And no tacos, no nachos, no chips, no popcorn. So amigos, you should love the Mayas and the Mexicans. We are very important for the world, okay? Come with me. This one is a public platform for the people. And I told you, every time you find offerings, you will find the god of the corn waiting for those offerings. Watch, who is there? The Chacmol, the god of the corn, waiting for those offerings with the plate over there, but the stone is completely destroyed. Okay? Watch, sometimes it's impossible to make a reconstruction because sometimes the stones were being destroyed by explosions. Yeah, explosions, dynamite. Who did that? The explorers. At the year 1527, Francisco de Montejo arrived to Chichen Itza, not to take pictures, not to take a tour with Amigo Tours. No, Francisco de Montejo was looking for gold. They had the idea that we had gold under the stones, and sometimes they will dynamite the buildings looking for this gold. For example, this one, and even the main one. If you go to watch the soul site was destroyed by explosions. It's impossible to make a reconstruction because the stones were made dust. We cannot take the dust to come back to make a new block. So the building will continue like this. It's impossible to make a restoration. Sad but true. Let's go, amigos. We are very close to the end. Can you see the pillars? Those pillars that you are watching are the 1,000 pillars. Should be the biggest building that we have, because this is only the front. If you want on your free time, you can pass through the pillars, because it's a big square made by all those pillars. You can go through the pillars to watch the remain of the 1,000 pillars. On the past, the pillars were being used like a market, and every pillar is a representation of the warriors, the eagle and jaguar warriors. As can you see on the corner, we have this big temple with mountain. Today is named the Temple of the Warriors. And the most important part is on the top. Watching the top, there on the top there are more pillars, but put attention on the pillars on the front. Those pillars on the front, on the top, are not warriors, are rather snakes. Can you see? Kukulkan. The most important part is on the top, in the middle of those two pillars. They will move your heart from the top of this one to the top of this one. Why? Sorry, amigos, we have to back under the sun to watch it. Come with me. Please, amigos, watch to the top. There on the top we have two pillars, and in the middle of the pillars there is our old friend. Remember? Mm-hmm. Who is on the top? The god of the what? Chacmol, god of the corn. Again, like a baby, like a fetus, taking the sun with this big plate on the belly. It's waiting for something, for what? Heart. Offerings, in this case your heart. This god of the corn is surrounded by the warriors and by Kukulkan, the main god on this place. So he's asking for a good war. They will put your heart, they will move your heart from the top of this one, and they will set on the Chacmol's belly, and they will burn it. Why they will burn it? Because he's asking for a good war to Kukulkan. Where is Kukulkan? It's the lightning, it's on the heaven. And the only way to go to the heaven is through the ashes. Through the ashes, Kukulkan will eat your soul, your blood, in case that you have, in this case, your chulel. For this reason, on the Sompantli, you were watching the warriors surrounded by the snakes, because they had a good war thanks to this offering. Beautiful, right? Maybe you're thinking that the Mayas were crazy, were bloody people, but remember, at the end we are not very different, because maybe the Mayas will sacrifice a person on the top, but it's the same on the Wild West. On the Wild West, they were hanging the people. On France, they used the guillotine to behead the people and were public events. The people used to go there to watch it and eat popcorn and ice cream while they were watching. So at the end, we are like the Mayas,